Winston Churchill once said that we shape our buildings and afterwards our buildings shape us. It points to really what the role of an architect is. We are literally imagining new societies, one brick at a time, if you will.
I mean, if we even go back to the very basic ancient buildings, the pyramids, the building science that was engaged in making the pyramids was huge.
The Roman Empire wouldn't have quite the same ring to it if we took out the artful and thoughtful architectural world that it created. We can understand civilizations through the architecture that they made, the things that we value. These things all come together, and it's a way that we can understand our own history, our own European history, or our Maori and Pacific history, or any other cultural history. We can do that through our architecture. We know in many cities around the world are organized enormously around the car. We also know that certain building types tend to be much more lavishly constructed than other ones. We might see an art gallery would come with a certain level of finish, which is quite different to, let's say, your average primary school. And in those differences, I think what we're seeing is a value system come out. And those things, I think, give us clues to how societies are organized and what matters to them. I would say that architecture is the art of building. So when we're thinking about what does that mean, it does mean that we need to understand our medium. We need to understand the technologies, the tools that we use to do our art.
So it's about preserving heritage, but also building new buildings so that they perform better and longer. So the ideal student for this program and for a career in building science is somebody who's curious and really wants to make the built environment where we spend 90% of our time a better place for people to be in. We're going to use resources well, so if you've done geography or economics or physics or any of the sciences, that's going to really help you.
I think one of the really nice things about architecture is that your background actually can be from lots of different places. You know, you might have a really strong technical background, and there's definitely a place within architecture for you. But you could also have a really strong creative background or a really good sort of cultural humanities background. And I think the lovely thing about is the discipline is that you can be a general practitioner or you could specialise in any one of those areas or a subset of those areas. I think if you got all your architectural news from a magazine shop, I think you could be forgiven for thinking that architects largely just supply the middle classes with luxury goods. And to some extent we do. It's true and it's a good thing, but it's not all we do. There's a huge range of roles that we play, from making kindergartens and schools to prisons, stadiums, train infrastructure. The whole city really is up for our attention.
So within New Zealand at the moment, we've got some major problems. One, we've got climate change, which is something we can't ignore. So how do we actually make buildings that are going to respond and to minimise the impact of climate change? So energy efficiency, net zero carbon, and some really big challenges and opportunities within that space. How to make buildings affordable so that we can have warm, dry, safe housing for everybody. And how to make buildings constructed better and quicker so that it also impacts on the deliverables of buildings.
How do we live together? It seems so simple. It's a basic question, but it's an incredibly complicated answer to which architecture contributes enormously.
So the degree is about the principles of how does a building work, starting from the ground up. So what's the soil? What's the foundations? How do you keep water out of the walls? How do you keep the building warm? How do you stop sound moving through the partitions so that if you're in a high density apartment, your neighbor's party late at night at 2 o'clock in the morning isn't going to stop you from going to sleep? How do you stop fire spreading from one building or tenancy to another? So it's all about how does the building perform and how do we make that building better?
I think the key thing about what you learn in this program is that you're mixing up three main threads of knowledge. The first one is probably technical. So there's a whole lot of technical things that you'll learn about the processes that we go through and also how buildings work. The second one is the cultural context of work, so the ideas, the world of ideas that shape architecture and that architecture shapes. And the third one is really your own creative voice. That's about you finding out what kind of architecture really pushes your buttons.
So there's a very strong theme about sustainability that runs through the courses that we do, and project management too. So how do you actually manage a project efficiently so that you get the deliverables on cost, on time, managing the risk so that everybody makes a reasonable profit at the end of the project?
I think the core of the whole program is studio. That's really where your creative voice gets nurtured. And everyone is an individual in studio. There's no universal rule about how to do good architectural projects. That forms the bulk of your curriculum, and then all the specialist subjects in history and theory or technologies feed into that.
So a lot of the things that students do is problem solving. So different types of problem solving, starting with simple case studies, building up to much more complex building types and more complex case studies. So a lot of it's very real, applied, focused projects because we live in our laboratory. It's not like we have to, in a chemistry lab where you have to go in and work at a bench. When you go home, when you go to work, when you go to the shops, you're in your laboratory and you can go around and look and see and touch and feel what it is that you're learning about. And so the projects and the problem solving that students do is very grounded in real life examples, whether it be a school or the house that they live in.
So in studio, which really simulates live projects, you'll start by thinking through the brief and you'll work through site analysis and those sorts of things often. And through sketching, drawing, modeling, those sorts of things, you'll start to imagine this new building. And you'll work with technologies that simulate things like thermal performance and sunlight access and those sorts of issues, right through to final kind of finished models, let's say, digital and physical models of a proposal.
It changes their life because they then think about the building that they live in, work and play in differently. So you can't go to the swimming pool and not now see where the defects are or where the services are. How can you do this better? How can you make this more sustainable? So it changes how you look at the world.
Well, you're never going to look at buildings, towns or cities the same way ever again. Most of our graduates do go into the construction industry as practicing architects, but some certainly go into other creative disciplines. Because Weta is here in Wellington, it's a relatively easy transition to go into the film industry, and some do. Lots of our technical, our tools cross over with that industry, but lots of others will go into some of the other arts. It could be fashion, could be pottery, it could be painting even.
Some go into working for the territorial authorities, like the councils. They might be working in a project management office where they're helping with the deliverables, the time, cost management, the resources, the plant, the labour for getting a project together. They might be working in an architectural office alongside other designers making the building performance and the detailing work. They might be working for a manufacturer looking at how to make innovative materials. But we've got graduates who are doing all sorts of things, from making innovative walls like the cross frame system. Or they might be working for Kaingaora, trying to build more innovative social housing. So the careers are really varied where they can go. You're going to be part of an industry where no 2 days are ever the same. You're not stuck at a desk, you're out and about, you're on construction sites, you're meeting with clients, you're looking at innovation in different ways to see how we can make buildings that perform better. You're part of a very fast-moving career where the problems are so huge, you're never going to be short of work. There's a huge demand for building science graduates.
You know, I've lived in some amazing cities around the world, Amsterdam, Rome, Sydney, London, and they're all great, but Wellie's better than all of them. You know, it's so colourful, it's so easy to walk around, there's a constant banging in to other people and other disciplines, other creatives, and I really, really love it for that.
One, it's really compact, there's good accommodation, really good cafes and a vibrant social life for students close to the university. But an important feature is that a building science program that's embedded in a school of architecture gives really good experience and grounding in terms of the different disciplines that you're exposed to while you're doing your study. So you're going to be working with architectural historians and design theory, as well as the building science. So it balances out the experiences and the knowledge that you get as a student. And but we also, being very close and connected to industry, we have lots of guest lectures come in, and there's opportunities for students to get out and to see what the practitioners are doing, so that you get lots of real life case study and practical knowledge too.
Well, the Wellington School of Architecture, I think, is incredibly special. We have all these disciplines under one roof, and more we need graduates and practitioners who can slide easily across disciplines and collaborate at the drop of a hat. That is the way that we work. It is massively in demand around the world. It makes us unique in New Zealand, and it makes us rare in the world.
So the technology that is coming about is really significant, which is really going to change how a building is put together.
100 years ago, our buildings, towns and cities were vastly different to the buildings we're making today. And in 100 years' time, all we can be sure about is that they'll be very different again. And it's going to be a fun ride to get there.